amazing.
Dr. Dave Luce, and I suppose you could call me the inventor of the Polymoog keyboard. In order to put this instrument in perspective, I'd like to give you a little historical background. Names such as Bob Moog, Walter Carlos, Garth Hudson, Keith Emerson come to mind in discussing the development of the Polymoog keyboard. Incorporating these ideas of all of these people has helped us to refine the concept of preset control as well as variable control, which makes the instrument more playable. This technical background is necessary to help you understand better the performance capabilities of the instrument. Perhaps the most important part of the development of the Polymoog was the development of a special integrated circuit or chip. Without this component, the size of the Polymoog would be many times its present size, and the cost of the Polymoog would be several times its present cost. Creating the Polymoog cost $500,000, of which a significant fraction was spent for designing this special integrated circuit. When notes are played on the touch-sensitive keyboard of the Poly, the chips are activated. The chips generate the basic sound using inputs provided by the player, either through the preset controls or through the variable controls. The timbre of the sound is then further modified using either the filters or the resonator sections on the Poly. The Polymoog works the way a musician thinks. Mike Boddicker, a prominent Los Angeles studio musician, can best demonstrate the translation of our electronic breakthrough to the performance of music.
To begin to play the Polymoog, we first focus our attention to the center of the console, which is a series of presets called modes. At the touch of a button, we have our choice of 8 basic sounds. Let's listen to a few. Here's piano. Strings. Harpsichord. Organ. Clavinet. Even one selection that places the Poly in a completely variable mode, allowing you to program your own sounds using the sliders. Now that we've covered the building blocks of the Polymoog, let's get into the unique features that allow us to become more creative. We'll start with the vibes mode. And vary that sound by bringing up the VCF slider. Thank you. I'll modify it by bringing in the loudness contour and then raising the resonator slider so that the clavinet mode becomes a double reed sound. What you've been hearing here are just a few of the possibilities. There are thousands of variations. Here's another interesting variation of the piano mode. An additional feature of the Polymoog is that you can split the keyboard. On the upper four octaves, I'll play clavinet with wah-wah, and on the lower part of the keyboard, I'll play a bass line. To demonstrate one of the capabilities of the Polymoog pedal, I'll use it to bend pitch. I'm a studio player, and I like the Poly because it's fast to program, and thus it saves me studio costs. But because it is easy to program, it also lends itself beautifully to live performance.